Hi, this is Ali and you're watching the ChatGPT Features video series on Learn Awesome. In this video, we shall discuss memory and retention features of ChatGPT. Let's begin by discussing what memory is. As per Wikipedia definition, memory is a faculty of the mind by which data or information is encoded, stored, and retrieved when needed. It is the retention of information over time for the purpose of influencing future action. If past events could not be remembered, it would be impossible for language, relationships, or personal identity to develop. I must say they are pretty neat definitions that let us build understanding of what memory is. Since we are talking in terms of ChatGPT, one should note that there are two types of memory at play here. One is the memory it takes for ChatGPT application to function, that is the data captured, stored, and used to train the models. Big chunk of above definitions apply to that. ChatGPT, or should we say OpenAI, uses your conversation history to train and improve the model. It has, at any given time, access to conversations of hundreds of millions of people, even if they delete them as they claim. This requires a lot of memory, but from perspective of our video, we are not concerned about this memory. This is probably being added in the cloud by adding more machines. When we refer to memory going forward, we would mean the memory ChatGPT specifically has about you, the user. By default, ChatGPT has no memory, but as discussed in the last video about context and instructions, it slowly begins to use conversation history as memory to add more beef to the responses it generates. It's your job to add context and instructions to get meaningful interactions from ChatGPT. We won't be repeating that in detail here, except that the context window used by ChatGPT-3 is limited to 4,000 tokens, but GPT-4 based versions would get a major upgrade of 32,768 tokens. The real reason for coming up with this video is the new feature called Custom Instructions in ChatGPT. This feature saves you from adding context about yourself and instructions to format response by saving some context and instructions permanently. It's like adding a hard drive to your computer without which it wipes out as soon as it reboots. So this new feature, accessible on the interface using the three dots, allows you to tell ChatGPT about yourself and how would you like it to respond. The about yourself part is the context part, where you can tell ChatGPT about what kind of work you do, what is your education and experience level, what interests you, where you live, etc. Not random information about yourself, but information that would help ChatGPT to give you more personalized response. The example they themselves provide is that of a teacher, which provides information about what level teacher she is, so she doesn't have to repeat that the topics she queries are for developing lessons plans for third grade science class. That way, when she queries anything like electrical circuit, ChatGPT would spare her the graduate level complex intricacies of electricity and would keep the response understandable to kids, without her explicitly requesting it each time. The next part, that is how would you like it to respond, is the instructions about the output formatting. It's like some setting defaults. For example, would you like answers to be detailed or summarized? Do you want them to be formal or informal, etc.? You always need to be careful on what information you are divulging over the internet. For pessimists amongst us, we hear about the stored data being sold or abused by small and big names alike all the time. With shady play with words in privacy statements and default opt-in setup when you sign up without reading privacy statements. And from that perspective, who cares what privacy statement have to say anyway? But if we go that extreme with this, we can't connect the computer to the internet ever. So we'll stick to the pragmatic optimist version and let's have a look at how we can control your data with ChatGPT. We already discussed your conversations are used by a default opt-in to train ChatGPT model and are retained for 30 days at the moment. You have the option to opt out of model training using your conversation history via explicit actions on OpenAI website. You can even disable history retention via data controls provided. I want to talk with specific reference to the two fields introduced with custom instructions where you are providing information about yourself. Now you are doing that with the intent of getting better response from ChatGPT, but you are also providing personal information online, which can be used in ways you don't anticipate. So best to be careful and selective. Best to avoid any financial or sensitive information which can be harmful in case of a data leak or something. Like, it's best if you don't try to ask ChatGPT to remember your ATM pin code. OpenAI may be a very honorable organization dedicated to data privacy, but it's a valuable target for hackers and people with less honorable intent. The possibility of data leak and data abuse is always there. Just like words you use in conversations, once you say them, you no longer control them. It applies both to your physical and personal life and your life online. Be careful, be selective. It's a big slide, and in hindsight, I should have made a separate video for this topic, but too late for that. Hopefully you know enough about custom instructions and memory retention of ChatGPT by now. If you like this content, please like and subscribe to be notified of upcoming content. As always, thanks for watching. Goodbye.